Bringing in Yuar Bhatt, Managing Director of Dalton Capital Advisors. He's joining us on the show right now. Mr. Bhatt, thanks very much for taking the time. What have you made of the market environment right now?
Well, it is drifting downwards, and I think that's the way it will go till at least we have some sort of certain news on the election front. Even otherwise, if you really see internationally also, there is not much progress in the trade talks between US and China. Brexit is a complete muddle. You have probably some emergency coming in US, and you have the Venezuelan problem, I think, getting a bit more serious.
Yeah.
So I think nothing seems to be adding up to at least a bullish market as of now. Yeah. And here we have elections, and rhetoric will start playing out full steam now. And the results also have not been exactly very great for the market to really take a U-turn and start scaling new highs.
Right. You know, how much importance are you placing on these events? If you were to take a call from a longer term horizon, say a 3 to 5 year outlook, because you know we've been getting comments from international asset management companies that have an India exposure, and they seem to believe that all this is just noise that you can cut out because they're pretty optimistic on the India long term story, and they use these as opportunities to enter.
Absolutely. I think, I mean, the long-term story is still very much intact. But the fact of the matter is, over the last, say, about a year or year and a half, there has been front-ending of potential earnings growth. And that has really not played out. So that is why there is now, at this level, the earnings growth do not really justify these valuations. So therefore, I think there is probably some correction that can happen because of these events. But that is not to say that the long-term things are bad. Things are going to be much better in the long-term. But I think there could be some sort of price adjustments because the earnings growth that we've been expecting for, you know, last several quarters has really not played out as yet.
Yeah. and some of the initial hits on numbers also seem to be taking a back seat. I mean, Ashok Leyland, case in point, big jump yesterday after the numbers, but cooling off. It's happened to a clutch of other auto ancillaries as well, wherein if they manage to surprise on the day of the results, post that, the overall sentiment around autos seems to be taking over. What are your thoughts here?
Well, I think autos have been actually playing out very well, even when the economy was not doing all that well. Now probably the economy is going to be in a much better shape. So it is, I think it is sort of slightly cyclical. It is not really something that is going to last for a long time. I think autos will probably revive, probably a quarter or two. But I think as of now, we are in a bad shape as far as autos are concerned. And that is getting reflected in even the ancillary stories.
So stay away?
I think if you're a long-term investor, these are very good opportunities for even in autos. But you know, you might have to hold on for some, probably a couple of quarters with that pain. But I think after that, things should look much better.
Okay. Are we staring at a two private airlines scenario in India? Do you think that? I mean, what did you make of this debt resolution plan? And more importantly, what does this mean for the other two listed private carriers, if anything?
Well, the way things are going, I think all these airlines will be eventually owned by banks.
Banks
will compete in the in a different arena now. But I think, I mean, they are in a muddle as it is. So therefore, I think it will take some time because banks are not going to be long-term investors in these stocks. They look for the first opportunity to get out. And finally, it should be some entrepreneur who has to run this. And it would be another airline company or some new breed of investors or entrepreneurs who will come and make a good deal out of this. But as of now, it is sort of status quo for some time, and it is, you know, holding one's head above water is the concern now.
But what does that do for the actual operations? I mean, while you're saying 51% is being held by lenders and primarily banks, I mean, they have no experience in running an airline company. So in aspect of running the day-to-day business, while you're staying afloat right now, that's giving you that buoyancy, but the longevity of the business is something that is of prime importance.
Well, that has been the case. I mean, in airlines, demand is never a problem.
And for Jet Airways, I mean, right now, you're talking about banks looking at the first opportunity to exit. It doesn't look like they're going to be exiting in a big hurry right now, at least for Jet.
Well, I think, they will need more and more injection of capital, yeah. whether it is through long-term debt or through equity. And, this is just a conversion. There is going to be much more debt capital that they would need. I think the banks would probably provide that for the present. But I think it is probably, you know, at least the next crisis doesn't seem to be very, very, very much around the corner as long as the banks are there to support. And now that banks are owning it, so they cannot really write it off very easily. So therefore, they will have to keep pumping more and more. I mean, if you really see, this was probably the case of this famous airline, East West Airline. So the banks kept pumping in more and more money till one day it collapsed. So it may not be so here, but I think banks need to...
You're painting a slightly more gloomier picture than, you know, dousing the excitement of the debt recast plan.
Debt recast plan is there, but I think it'll need more and more money to stay afloat. And unless there is a fundamental change in the economics of the business, it doesn't look like as if there's going to be a great turnaround story now.
Yeah, well, for some people, it was an excuse of a debt recast plan as well. I think the con call today will probably be able to throw more light, because otherwise, this hides more than it reveals. The gap between the money that they have to service versus what they are getting, quite stark today. You know, one technical trigger that played out over the last 6 days was the sell-off in some of the PSU names, or some of the names which are a part of the Bharat 22 ETF as well. We've seen that consistent pullback. Mm. In today's session, there is a bounce back into all of these names. Mm. Are PSUs untouchables, or some of the companies which have come out with good numbers could well be looked at? A Coal India, a case in point, the numbers seem very, very strong. Would you selectively look at them at all, or are they just a complete avoid?
No, I think they represent reasonably good value, some of them. Mm-hmm. And it is not as if they're terribly mismanaged. They're showing some earnings growth. And I think the government is hell-bent on making a success of them. And so therefore, as long as that will to make a success out of these are is very much there, I think, and they're quoting at bottom valuations. So I think there is certainly, I mean, there may not be great fireworks there, but I think you can certainly make some decent money in these stocks at rock bottom valuations.
But it is the general tendency to stay away from anything that's government led. I mean, the mindset and the psychology is such of the market.
No, the returns too, right, yeah. Devina? And they haven't been exactly great.
And just the play on dividend.
It's a play on dividend, and since the government always needs more and more money, so therefore the dividend yield will continue will continue to be around these levels. But I think as long as there is no great competition from the private sector, they seem to be doing well. But once there is competition, like what happened in banking or in airlines or in telecom, they tend to give a very bad account of themselves. But at least those where there is no great competition, I think it may be worth holding on till there is competition.
Okay, well, Coal India shareholders, watch out for commercial coal mining. Does that change or alter the thing a bit or no? In which case, Mr. Bhatt, my final question to you, where is it that you are comfortable putting money, if at all, or are you putting money with a bit of a hiatus? Stay out for the time being, watch the whole election drama unfold. Maybe there's a better time to invest post-June.
Well, for retail investors, that is the way to go, because they should not be really playing into all this volatility. But for those who are traders who really want to make money on these things, I think it might be a good idea for them to, if they need to be invested in equities, they can play around with, as you get opinion poll results and stuff like that. You can take bets on that. But otherwise, if you really see, even in the Nifty, other than that, probably top 10 companies, all others are available at huge discounts. So therefore, you can probably evaluate these and start buying into, suppose you have to put 100 rupees, probably buy 25, 30 rupees worth of it now, and wait for which way the election results will take the market.
All right, Mr. Bhatt, we leave it at that. Thank
Pleasure.
You so very much for joining
Thank
in.
You. Thank you.